Dave and Larry's Scary Adventure. Halloween was approaching fast, and the engines were making preparations. Excursion business was booming faster. Even Sean was sent out to help out on the excursions. That evening at Springfield, the engines were talking about what to do on Halloween till Mr. Hamilton showed up to give their assignments. Alright, engines, listen up. Sonic, take an excursion to Toledo, Ohio.
Reporting for duty, sir.
Races, yes, expose. Take a freight train to the Collier Yard in Petersburg, Virginia.
Yes, sir. Right away.
Nicholas, you're taking an overnight train to Toronto.
Wait, what? At night? Sir, that line is haunted by ghost trains. Can you please switch my job?
Alright, I'll assign you to help Arthur and Dakota on their train bound for Pittsburgh. I'll have Dave and Larry do the run to Toronto.
Just when I was about to make another Tales on CP Railroad episode? Fine, but at least we'll escape from those losers.
Benjamin, Bridget, and Timothy, usually have the day off for now. Nice, a day off for my girlfriend Bridget and my friend Timothy. Maybe we could spend the day off making preparations for Halloween.
You definitely said it, Benjamin.
Ready to depart, Grace.
Ready when you are. Put the hammer down.
We have the right of way. Smell you later, dolly.
Seriously? How long till CSX Jose and Mires are gone? Dahlia, look out for the ghost. Got overtaken twice. This makes me and Larry mad.
Steve and Larry left Springfield on their way to Toronto. Later that night, Dave and Larry's journey was going well. But not for long.
why is the signal red?
I don't know. Maybe it's a signal malfunction, or if we have to wait for another train.
It's a ghost train and it's out to get me. Let's get out of here.
That's right, babe.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the ones who got scared by the ghost. Be quiet, Wallace. Don't remind us. Oh, whatever. Just park your train in the yard.
Then that CNU2G number 6208 fell off the broken bridge and he never returned again. Not in his normal form, anyway. He still exists, but as a ghost. And he haunts the rails year-round. Better be aware of your surroundings, or he could get you next.
Ghosts? Pah. Your story's a ton of baloney. As are the rest of yours. Ghost stories are just fake and I don't believe any of it.
And I couldn't tell my story without being criticized by you, Mark. Of course this one is fake. It takes place in a different universe anyway, the one I dreamed up myself. You mean to tell me that I can't have fun on my own time, is that it?
But you're making it seem like it's real, which it's not. And even if they were real, they wouldn't dare mess with an important engine like me.
Is that why you think it's fun to biff my girlfriend Lily into the end of the siding? Or to talk trash about steam locomotives and disbelieve my ghost stories, which I should mention are appropriate for the season?
Whatever. Anyways, I better get ready for my run at the Capitol Lane. Wait, why is there a red signal? It's a ghost train. I better get into here. Hi, what's going on?
I'll tell you. You got scared by that ghost train.
What? No, I didn't. I don't even believe in ghosts and those dumb ghost stories.
Oh yes you did, Mark. That ghost really got you good.
Scaredy engine, Mark is such a scaredy engine.
Shut up, Annette. Don't remind me. Anyways, I gotta collect my train. Hopefully I can leave this train and pull it alone without any other Amtrak locomotives.
Just wait till Mark has to trail.
Are you ready to go?
No. Anything but your stupid Nightwish music. This is gonna be the worst 18 hours of my life.
Well, too bad. In other words, have fun trailing your disgrace to Amtrak.
Well, looks like we have two scary engines.
Oh no, they're about to tease us over our ghost encounter.
That's right, you're just in time for a marathon of Tom's Tank Engine, Tugs, Galaxy Railways, and other shows we enjoy watching.
You two dumb caps shall enjoy your show, especially the spookiest episodes from Season 5.
Oh man, this is gonna be torture.
Agreed! How can this get worse?
Afraid of no ghosts.